Hi everyone, welcome to the studio vlog for October. This one starts a little early on September 30th, as that was the day I unboxed and set up my new overhead rig for streaming and filming videos. Hooray! Thank you very much to supporters on Twitch during the Creative Showcase and also my patrons. This Glidegear OH100 has already made such a huge difference to my setup, but I'll talk a little more about that later on. In the box, you receive a metal bracket to hang your camera on the stand, as well as the three metal bars that form the stand. You also get the feet and braces for the feet that connect them to the stand. Everything is very sturdy, the parts are made from metal and are quite heavy. Even though there are holes in the feet for you to screw the stand down to your desk, I feel like it is so solid and stable I don't need to do this. The camera bracket has a slot on both sides, so you could even hang multiple cameras, your phone with the included phone bracket, or an extra light, microphone or monitor from it. As well as the camera bracket, each of the three bars have holes, so you can hang small lights or cameras at almost any point for extra camera views or better lighting. I found the stand was relatively quick and easy to assemble, but I did need help getting everything together when attaching the top bar to the side bars. Good morning! It is Friday, October 1st. And this is how this is looking. So it's pretty big, but when I'm sitting at the table, it's really good because there's nothing in my way. You can see I've still got like some of my old microphone arms and things back here. I still have to hook all of that up. So I haven't added the camera to this yet or anything like that, but this is how it's looking on the table, and I'm super excited to set everything up. I'm just waiting for some extra attachments and things so that I can attach like my microphone and the little extra webcam that I use for a palette cam to the side, and then I'll be able to show you guys how that looks. I'm hoping to pick those up today, but it might be maybe another couple of days before I get those. But yeah, no more of these kind of like arm things hanging off the side of the table and getting in the way, so that's going to be super cool. Hooray! I printed out the limited edition print for October, which was of a poppy flower that I painted during a Patreon livestream demo. I really love how this beautiful painting looks as a limited edition mini print. weekend, we went out for brunch and then went to the beach for a break. The wind at the beach was still a bit chilly, but the sunshine was lovely and warm, and we had a nice relaxing time. After the weekend was over, it was back to painting, and I was very excited to keep working on my seamstress moth painting. I am close to the end of this painting now, and I added a few of the last finishing touches during this painting session. This painting is part of my new series called Opera Moths. Each painting features a moth or moths along with other characters that live and work in and around the Paris Opera House. If you want to see more of the series, I am streaming oil painting on Mondays and Tuesdays over on my Twitch channel. I will put the channel link in the description if you would like to pop over and say hi. Everyone, it is Tuesday, October 12th, and I just wanted to share a sticker sheet that I'm working on. So these are some little exercise kiwi stickers, and I'm just making these as a test for me to start with, because I just want to try making some planner sticker sheets. So these are ones that I thought I would find quite useful for myself, and then eventually, hopefully, I might be able to make proper stickers. I actually went and bought out some paper sticker sheets over the weekend, only to find that they have like really large branding on the back. Like these big black logos that actually show through to the sticker paper on the front, which is not optimal. So I'm just going to use that for testing, unfortunately, and maybe try and find a different lot of sticker paper after I have done some tests. In another update, the overhead camera rig from Glidegear is working fantastically for streaming, and I'll pop in some footage from yesterday's stream where I was doing some test close-ups of a seamstress moth and just using it for that, and it's been working really, really well, so I'm so happy with it. It's really great for my back and my posture while I'm streaming, because I don't have to lean around everything, and yeah, it works really well. Tuesday, I did a makers and crafting stream, and I did a test print and cut of my exercise kiwi stickers. I was so happy with how these sheets turned out, and I've been using them in my diary, and they're very cute. I trimmed the first lot by hand as I wasn't sure how to kiss cut as well as cut the sheet all the way through right around the edge of the sheets. I gave it another go with the Cricut and added a second cut to the file so that it went around the edge of the sheet twice and cut all the way through. This was my first time trying to make kiss cut sticker sheets with the Cricut and is something I've wanted to do for a very long time. I started out with one of the original Silhouette portrait machines quite a few years ago, and the print and cut function on that machine never worked quite right, but these ones are perfect. Good morning everyone, it is Monday the 18th of October and my desk is still a mess from last week, so I gotta go ahead and clean this up. But what I want to do today is finish off this Wizard of Oz piece, transferring the sketch to paper for that, the watercolour paper, because I didn't get very far with this particular one in the stream at the end of last week. And over the weekend I found the Crayola Colours of the World coloured pencils at the warehouse. I'm pretty excited to swatch these and try them all out. I think it will be fun to try these. And I also want to sign the poppy prints and take photographs of them and put them up on the website, and I'd like to get all that done within the next hour and a half. Let's go, and yeah, hopefully I will get everything done. This is another painting in the Opera Moth series and is still very much a work in progress. This lady moth is the ballet mistress at the opera. Most of the time so far has been taken up with painting all of the fluff on her face and the tiny scales on her wings. This moth is based on a black morph peppered moth. Continuing with my Cricut sticker adventures, I wanted to design a cute sticker set. I made designs based on owls crossed with various fruits. In the set there are peach, strawberry and pineapple owls, and here I am creating a design for a kiwi fruit owl. I drew all the designs for these stickers in Procreate on the iPad. To make the kiwi fruit owl super extra kiwi, I added a speech bubble with the words, "not even." This is a play on the New Zealand slang phrase, "not even owl," except he's a kiwi fruit owl, so he's a not even owl. I bought some postage for Patreon parcels, and this is the first time I have bought stamps in bulk. I'm very glad to have everything I need to sort out postage so I don't have to go into a post office at the moment. I can just package everything up and pop the letters in the street post office box down the road. I also got some A5 size chipboard sheets to save time. I had been cutting A4 sized sheets down to size, but this took a lot of extra time as my small guillotine wasn't really strong enough to go all the way through the chipboard. The resulting cut was a bit messy as well. These will look much better. Thank you. For this month's Patreon print, I drew a New Zealand native kia bird in Procreate on the iPad. He's almost a companion piece to the Haast's eagle print from earlier in the year, and I placed him high up in his mountain habitat. October, and it's a bit after 2 o'clock, so I've just been doing some post-stream stuff, and I am waiting for the new desk to be delivered, so probably in a couple of days I will not be using this old desk anymore, which is pretty exciting. It will give me a lot more space, and also the new desk is a standing desk, so I'm really looking forward to that for streaming. What I'm going to do while I'm waiting for it to be delivered, because I know that it's on the truck at the moment, is I'm going to cut up these prints for Patreon, and I've also got the postcards ready to be printed and everything, so I'm going to print those out and cut those as well, so everything's ready to go. And this month is also the first month that I'm going to be sending out postcards to Patreons in the $10 tier, so I'm pretty excited about that. And I'm hoping eventually I can afford to get proper postcards printed. That is the goal. Right now I'm just printing them myself, which is fine for the art prints, but the postcards, you know, they need to be weatherproof. So I'll probably just end up sending them the ones that are going by themselves in a little envelope. But yeah, I'm going to go and do that, and yeah, just sit here and wait for the desk to show up while I'm working. Out of the printer. Just waiting for the ink to finish drying, but doesn't that look beautiful? I'm so happy with this inkjet cardstock that I bought off TradeMe. It's beautiful and glossy, and everything just looks so much brighter and more saturated. Like, that's exactly what I was hoping it would look like, so I am so happy. I was using quite thin cardstock for the postcards to send out for Patreon because that was all I had. So just to show you an example, this is actually the last one left over from last year's Patreon postcards, and it's quite thin and quite dull. Like, I do like the matte finish, but yeah, this is just so much nicer and it will look so much more professional. Even though they're still not waterproof because they're just printed on my inkjet printer by me here at home. But these are the ones that I send out with little handwritten notes on them, so they're not actually going through the mail by themselves, they're going out in a parcel. And the ones for the $10 tier I'm going to put in a little envelope as well, so they will be nice and protected. But yeah, cute! Really happy! Okay, now I have to trim everything and start packaging up the parcels for this month. Thank you. Thank you for watching this month's studio vlog. I hope you enjoyed it, and also thank you very much to my Patreon community and my supporters over on Twitch. If you would like to check out exclusive art, behind the scenes updates, and get early access to videos like these and more, consider checking out my Patreon. I'll be back again soon with another art video. Bye!